we on the move again, let's go. Red Dude is on the move again, let's go. Red Dude is on the move again, let's go.
You're still watching Red Dude on the Move on EIT with me and Jerry Sakowin, Jerry with a Strawberry. This is our trending segment. Yes, where we talk about issues that are trending on the social media platforms and of course issues that are currently making the rounds. All right. But of course, this week edition will be taking a new shape entirely because I've got two gist partners joining me on the show. Why not pull a seat and join us on this very interesting segment of the show? As I introduce to you my guest on the segment, on my immediate left, Temi Dayo Oluwafemi. She is a social media specialist and also a presenter as well. Welcome to Gbedu Trending Segment.
Thank you for having me.
You're looking so trendy yourself.
Uh-huh.
You are the segment.
Thank you.
And the presenter. And of course,
thank
on my extreme left is a social media strategist, artist manager, and of course, journalist as well, Desmond Ikechima. Welcome, Desmond.
Thank you very much for having me.
Nice to have you here. So many gists have been really, really hot on the social media recently. Rugged Man coming out to say he would like to be an actor, but looking at the pay the actors, the male actors are getting, doesn't look to be commensurate with that of the female folks in the industry. Well, it got me a bit taken aback because, in all honesty, if you look at how the female artists or actors are posting trending stuff, buying houses, buying cars, expensive jewelries, you want to kind of believe or tilt towards Redman's argument. Temi Dayo, don't you think perhaps these female actresses or these actresses usually have this big girl seated somewhere responsible for all these flashy cars and houses?
Well, I don't think so. I think it's hard work.
Hard work?
Yes.
How hard is the work? Let's get to the nitty gritty.
The work is hard. Very hard, of course. If you're a producer, if you're an actor, you would understand the stress that is put into producing a movie. And thank God for the satellite TVs we have now to buy movies with good money. So if you're a producer, you produce your movies, you put everything into play to make sure that your movie is top-notch. And then you sell to one of the satellite TVs now, you make your money.
Wow.
And then the good part of this is that you can keep making your money forever. Because if you're produced well, it's like a continuous thing. You sell for 6 months now, you get it back 6 months, you sell to another TV station, you sell for 6 months, you get it back. Every TV station is content.
Wow, so amazing. And I'm wondering why the male actors, the actors are not really doing exactly these, and it's not fetching them exactly how much it's fetching the female actors as well. Well, it is entertainment sometimes. It may not really be for one as it is for the other. I'm sure Ikechima agrees with me.
Well, I slightly disagree because you and I know that as far as entertainment is concerned, there is just one code. Actually, what the male does is what the female does. So it's not like there's one god for the female and there's another
god for the male.
But the issue is that there are some stories told behind the scenes, and that's the reason why it looks like it is favorable.
I'm interested in those stories, but anything behind the scenes catches my attention very
fine,
fast.
Fine. All of us are gossip people. And that's not what gist is, anyway. So, but the argument that actually caught my fancy or caught my attention recently was that of Rugged Man, when Rugged Man made a statement of why, you know, asking a question, why it looks like the industry is favoring the female above the males. And then one actress, which I don't call her name, actually
came out in defense,
in a different color and responded and said different things, you know. Her argument is understandable. But on the other hand, we're not trying to tarnish the image of those who are honestly doing
it. That's stating the obvious.
But the world we live in the entertainment sector, does it really favor the females? The answer is yes. Why does it favor the females above the males? It's because the feminine gender is more of a softer gender.
Okay.
You know, every man, every man rather, will always want to favor a female over a male.